Everyone in Europe are usually doing the research for this because it's good for the repair cells. So anti-aging.
Anti-aging.
So this is the brain tonic, brain power. So the shape is like brain. My mom gave me a knowledge from her experience, like more than 30 years of experience in disability for fall down and cannot speak and unconscious and just lay down in the bed and change the habit for the healthy food and also drinking jamu. And after 3 months, my father healthy again until now.
Need to stop.
¿Sabías que la medicina tradicional de Indonesia existe una bebida a base de plantas medicinales que es la clave para tratar sus dolencias en el día a día? En el episodio de hoy entrevisto a una mujer que ha dedicado su vida a esta bebida, tanto a prepararla como a enseñar sobre ella. Te hablo de una familia que se ha dedicado generaciones al estudio de esta bebida. ¿Te apetece descubrirlo? Bueno, hoy estamos en Ubud, Bali, en Indonesia. Y en este episodio creo que te va a aportar mucho valor conocer a esta mujer y todo lo que ella está realizando en su día a día. ¿Te vienes? Antes de comenzar, acuérdate de suscribirte al canal de Planta Tu Salud, darle like a este vídeo y activar las notificaciones. ¡Vamos a ello!
Vuelta al mundo a través de las plantas medicinales.
En el capítulo anterior visitamos el proyecto de Anga, en la isla de Bali, donde nos siguió descubriendo plantas medicinales utilizadas en la isla de los dioses. Hablando sobre el propósito de lo que había creado, las plantas medicinales que lo rodeaban e incluso nos contó sobre ceremonias balinesas y su relación con las plantas medicinales. Vimos plantas como el patchouli, el bigote de gato, la albahaca sagrada, la cúrcuma y el jengibre, entre otras. Si aún no has visto este capítulo, aprovecha y vete a verlo ahora antes de seguir en esta nueva aventura herbal. Seguimos en Indonesia, en la isla de Bali, descubriendo personas interesantes con conocimientos tradicionales herbales que seguro te sorprenden. El capítulo de hoy viene con un preparado herbal muy especial. La moto es nuestra mejor aliada para llegar a los lugares más remotos y no quedarnos atrapados por el tráfico de algunas partes de la isla. A veces algunos sitios son complicados de alcanzar. Pensaba que iba a ser más difícil y peligroso conducir una scooter aquí, pero la verdad que me está encantando la experiencia. Con todo lo que me rodea, el viaje se hace muy ameno y siempre es sorprendente ver cómo los balineses se desplazan durante su rutina con la moto a veces cargada de la forma más sorprendente que te puedas imaginar. La parte que más disfruto es cuando empiezan a aparecer los arrozales y nos adentramos en lugares más rurales que siempre van acompañados de templos. Lugares con una energía especial que te hacen admirarlos en todo momento. La persona que entrevistaremos hoy nos espera en el corazón de Ubud. Su nombre es Ayu y, como veremos a continuación, es una mujer medicina experta en una bebida natural tradicional indonesia con mucha historia, el jamu. Ayu ha dedicado su vida a ello y en el episodio de hoy nos abre las puertas a este conocimiento herbal que se transmite de generación en generación. Nos ha invitado a un lugar entre arrozales junto con su equipo donde han sacado todas las plantas medicinales útiles para realizar el jamu con nosotros. La verdad que es todo un honor formar parte de esto. Es una maravilla ver todos estos colores y sabores de las plantas medicinales. ¿Te sorprenden igual que a mí? Déjamelo aquí en un comentario abajo del vídeo contando un poquito lo que estás sintiendo. Y formar parte en la preparación de esta maravillosa bebida herbal medicinal en directo. ¡Vamos con ello!
So we are here in Ubud with a very special person in the traditional herbal medicine of Ubud and Indonesia. And I'm very grateful to stay here. So I want to introduce you, Ayu. And yeah, let's go. So who are you and what are you doing here in Ubud?
Okay, thank you, Raul. My name is Ayu. So I'm a herbalist, or people call me a jamu queen, and also I'm a holistic healing coach, and I started making jamu. It's been like since 2012, so it's been like 11 years for making jamu. So my mom gave me a knowledge from her experience, like more than 30 years of experience in research development for jamu. And then I learned about the jamu and then making the concoction, and also to know about the raw material for the medicinal plants and making the jamu, Indonesian jamu, actually.
Nice. Thank you. And to say to people a little introduction about jamu, because I think people who are watching us maybe don't know nothing about jamu. What you will tell in little words, what is jamu?
Okay, jamu is the original about the herbal drink in Indonesia. And jamu, it's mean from Japanese language or old Japanese language, jampi and usada. Jampi, it's mean like mantra, belief system, or like treatment, healing. And then usada, it's mean health, or we call it like health from medicinal plants, or maybe from animals, but from the medicinal purpose. And so jamu, it's mean like maintenance the health from the medicinal plants or animal for the purpose medicine. So we must believe it and grow the belief system in there.
Like, okay. Thank you very much for telling a little bit. After, we will speak about how it's done and what it's used for. But I want to ask you about how did you start with everything and about your family. How was your first encounter with the herbal medicine or with jamu? It was because of your mother or because of your family that you start liking to work with plants or starting this connection with the jamu? How was the start of this?
Okay, that time I just want to preserving our culture about jamu to the next generation, because it's important to maintain our health with the natural treatment, because I just see like my mom always give me the jamu from childhood until now, and for the anti-inflammation, antibacterial, or sometimes for longevity. And I feel to myself, and then I want to share to our society and our next generation to know not everything that can be instantly for our health, but we must to know about the long short term to how to maintain our body, our mind, our emotion too, like holistic health. So we talk jamu in a holistic health.
Okay. Thank you very much for telling a little bit of your background and your story.
Yes.
And now, if you want, can we pass to the part of the interview about explaining a little bit of jamu more in deep, and about what we have here, all these beautiful and super good smell plants?
Yeah, okay. Let's introduce one by one.
Okay, so now we are going to pass to see all these plants that jamu, very kind, she has carried with her and her team, which is there. Maybe we will show you after. So, Aji, what we have here, all these crazy and beautiful plants?
I explain one by one, maybe from here.
Okay.
Because this is for the similar ginger in the world, but we have different ginger for jamu. This is the small ginger. We call jahe emprit. And then...
And it's more spicy than the common one that we have in Europe.
Yes, more spicy. And then this is the... We call kencur. Kamperfia galanga, or aromatic ginger in English. So this is same botanical family.
Okay.
And also this turmeric, or we call kunyit. And this is galanga, we call laos or lengkuas. And this
one, the turmeric, was the this is the Japanese turmeric.
Yeah,
it's different to the turmeric that we normally.
Yes, because usually in Europe, this is called curcuma, but we have a lot of curcuma in here. Like this, this is curcuma santorisa, but turmeric, curcuma domestica or longa, curcuma longa. And then for this, can see. Okay, this is the red ginger, so the smell is different when you can smell. This is more spicy than this.
Than the normal ginger.
More spicy.
Yeah, it's incredible because in Europe we only like kind of use one type of ginger, and then we come here to Indonesia and you have all type of gingers.
Yes, and maybe for note, because we have 33,000 for medicinal plants, but in the world there are more than 35,000 for the purpose medicine in the world. So
in Indonesia there are a lot of variety.
Yes, we have rich biodiversity for the medicinal plants,
because as you told me before, here in Bali and Indonesia, when you sit a plant, it grows all the time, right? So
yes, because we live in tropical island, rich with the sun and rain and also the soil, so everything can grow in here.
Okay.
Maybe about the shape, maybe more smaller in here, but we have rich medicinal plants.
Okay.
And also this is pandan leaves, and maybe you know this, lemongrass and lime, different with lemon. So more acid inside, and high vitamin C. And this is, do you know?
This is fresh. What's the name in Spanish of this one?
Tamarind.
Ah, we take it the other day in one in Sumbawa.
Yeah.
With this, the tamarind tree, but it was the, you know, the fruit.
Okay.
The long one from the tree.
Yes, and then inside.
And so good. Yeah, I really like the flavor of the tamarind.
Yeah. So like, this is high vitamin C too. And this is the arenga sugar. So different with coconut sugar. Usually, maybe you know about brown sugar, but you must to know brown sugar from what plant, because we have like many kind of plum leaves in here. Like coconut is palm leaf, and then arenga trees is palm leaf, but different fruits. So we have usually for jamu, usually we use arenga sugar.
Arenga sugar.
Yes, arenga sugar. So the fruits we call apa namanya? Kolang-kaling. Yes, different with coconut. Yeah, but you can use the coconut sugar, but usually we use arenga sugar because more sweet and it's good taste, I think.
So to put in perspective to the people that are watching us, you have carried all these plants because they are using the jamu, and we're going to show them a little bit how is the making of the jamu with some of these ingredients, no?
Okay, yeah. I will to explain and making the jamu after this.
Okay.
And then next.
Yeah.
Okay, next, this is noni roots. We call angkudu.
Angkudu. This is noni.
Noni. In English, noni. And this is, now everyone in Europe are usually to do the research for this, because it's good for the repair cells. So anti-aging.
Anti-aging.
And this is betel leaves. Yeah, betel leaves. Usually our grandmother using for chewing for the tooth, and yeah, the tooth more stronger, and also for the women for the antibacterial in menstrual period, and then this is, you know,
the incredible moringa.
Yes, superfood.
Yeah.
Moringa, and also this is Gotu Kola. So this is the brain tonic, brain power. So the shape is like brain. Yeah, like ginkgo biloba.
The theory of the signature, like the plant shows you how to use it, because as you said, it's very similar to the brain, you know? So the plant is saying to you that it's good for brain.
Yes. Okay, this is a fresh one, and we have a dried one in here.
So here I want to say to you, really thank you for carrying the fresh and the dry one. Right. Really incredible. Thank you very much.
You're welcome. Usually in Indonesia, not only for the fresh one we use, but also the dried one for making the jamu.
Mm-hmm.
Like this. This is turmeric.
Turmeric like
this one. Yeah. One, okay. And then dried one. Maybe again. And this is the ginger. Like this. This is ginger. But this is the dried one. This is lime, wine, and also this is curcuma santoriza or temulawak, we call.
Okay.
Javanese ginger or Javanese turmeric, because the curcumin. So yes, there's the rosella, red rice, sea salt, cloves, cardamom. Nah, this is different cardamom with Indian cardamom, because this is the original from Indonesia. Different shape, because we have different shape with the Indian cardamom, and color, wet color, and the smells and taste like mint. And this is nutmeg, cinnamon, and also sapan wood.
You have here
and also
this one, then
raw honey.
Oh, the honey.
This is our product.
After you have to speak to us about your product and your brand.
Yeah.
Okay, and so
cumin.
And the cumin. Cumin here. And with all this beautiful and incredible plants, what kind of jamu do you want to show to our audience?
Maybe beras kencur. Beras kencur, it's mean aromatic ginger with the rice. So usually for prevent the cold and flu, and usually maybe in the winter, people traveling to another city, another country, and then the immune system is getting low. So we can making beras kencur, jamu beras kencur.
Okay, good. And I want to ask you, before we go to prepare this jamu, what are the typical diseases that jamu is used for?
Usually for the antibacterial and anti-inflammation, and also for the what else, like longevity too, and
immune system
boosting the immune system. What else, like antioxidant.
Okay.
Yeah.
And if I want to use jamu, or someone that is watching us want to use jamu, how is the, like we say, the protocol or the time that you have to take it to feel the power of jamu and the action of jamu? How many times and how long in the time?
Okay, if the for promotion benefit, you can drink like one time in a day after meal, or yeah, depends. And then for the prevention, preventive benefit, usually like 1 until 2 times for a day. And for the curative benefits, usually like 2 until 3 times a day.
Okay, so the first one that you said, the promotion,
yes.
What is the use of promotion? What do you
promotion mean? Like to increase your system.
Okay.
And then the preventive to prevent from the disease also. Maybe you feel the symptom.
Okay.
When you get the flu, usually what the symptom? Like headache and sometimes muscle pain.
Mm-hmm.
What else? Sometimes sneezing.
You start to feel that something is not good in your
body. Yeah, you must to hear your body speak, messenger from your body, then you must hear, oh, my body is not good, so I must to making jamu to prevent it, the disease getting worse.
Okay.
And the curative, when you getting worse, because you don't hear your body, your mind, and then getting worse. Yes, so you must drink more than like 2 until 3 times a day.
And how much is the dose of like one dose would be like 1 cup like that?
Yeah, 1 cup like 100 until 150 milliliters.
Okay. So we can say as a resume, like if you want to more or less stay healthy, it's 1 time per day. If you want to prevent, it's like 2 per day. And if you are with the ill, like in the bad part, you can drink
more.
Even 3 times per day.
Yeah, like a chemical, chemical
every benzene. Every 8 hours.
But in medicinal plants or maybe jamu, we need time to heal. It's not like a chemical medicine, usually just 3 days when you get a flu. 3 days, like instantly you can get healed, but for jamu, maybe 1 week. So you must patient to heal your body with your conscious mind. Maybe you can change also your habit for eating meal to healthy food, also drinking jamu.
That is a thing that I try to tell all the time to the audience, the people that watch us and in my courses too, that herbal medicine is slow, it's not fast, it's not like 3.0 Wi-Fi. But it works in time and it's best for your body. But you have to be patient and constant, as you said.
Yeah.
And it's important too, as you said, that even if you take jamu or other herbal medicine, if you don't take care of your habits,
yes,
it will not work as it should be.
Yes.
It's important to take everything as in a holistic way.
Yes, holistic way. Maybe I want to share about, tell the story about my father.
Okay.
Yeah, like my father have allergic before, and then like accumulative after the allergic, usually he consumed the chemical medicine. Always.
What kind of medicine, like
antibiotic and anti-allergic.
Okay.
And then after he has 70 years old, it's getting worse because my father fall down and cannot speak and unconscious and just lay down in the bed and on the bed. And we just, what happened with my father and my mom and me, much to do change the habit from my father, because usually maybe my father in the his project in other city, it's not good for the habit for the eating and also not drinking the medicinal plants or jamu.
Okay.
So after that, we changed the habit for the healthy food and also drinking jamu. And after 3 months.
3 months.
Yeah,
oh.
3 months. Because the curative, for the treatment is curative, so take long because my father unconscious that time. So we need to need time to heal treatment. After that, my father healthy again until now.
And he's a thousand. He was 70.
He's 70, but he has now 75 years old. So yeah, he can walk again and driving a car again. That time, just laying on bed.
The power of patience and herbal medicine.
Yes.
And the knowledge of Ayu. Okay, so what are the plants that we are going to use to prepare the jamu that you want to show us? Which one you want to use?
This, kencur,
Sure, which is the spicy ginger bit?
Yeah, spicy ginger and ginger.
Okay.
And that rice. And also this is cinnamon, nutmeg, cloves, cardamom, we use it, and sea salt, and also this, tamarind, and then arenga sugar, and pandan leaves, lemongrass.
Wow, very well, jamu.
Lot of, because when we make a jamu, we have like formulation for the primary materials and secondary material and the tertiary material for the therapeutical effect.
So for this one, you were telling that these are jamu that we can use for this one that we are going to prepare now.
Yeah.
It's more focused on what kind of pathology or disease?
For the prevent flu and cold.
Prevent flu and cold. So the primary plants here would be the more the ginger or the...
Yes.
This one will be the most important.
This
most
important. Is
ginger.
This is the primary, and this is the primary.
The inflammatory power of the ginger.
Yeah.
Okay.
Because for the warm body.
Okay.
To warm it.
Okay. Perfect.
So, and also, oh yeah, also the rice.
And the rice.
Why rice? Because for the carbo, usually when we feel cold and flu, we don't have energy, so we need to hide the carbo, but we use the rice, but we use the red rice, so it's good lower glucose.
Okay, so it's different from the brown and the white, is because of the different glucose.
The glucose.
Okay.
Yeah.
Perfect. So let's jump to the preparation. What do you think?
Yeah.
Let's go.
Let's.
Okay. Okay, so now we are here ready, and Aju and me want to show too that we are not alone. We are with, what's the name of her?
Tuana.
Tuana?
Yeah.
Who are them?
Yeah, this is my team. This is my personalized fan. This is my team for helping me for Jamu workshop and also production and also everything.
So they are like a part of your brand of renown,
yes.
The Jamno experience that you create.
Yes, of course.
Okay, so terima kasih you two for staying here today with us. Okay, so let's prepare the Jamno.
Okay, maybe Tuana, I'm going to explain it.
So the step is roll the water.
Okay, so first step is like doing a decoction.
Yeah,
like boiling
the dried one first.
I do.
Next, add with some spice.
It cloves out.
Okay, so you are putting like 4 cloves more there.
Okay.
Some.
3 cardamom.
Cardamom. And you put the cardamom even with the exterior part, not only the inside.
Yeah.
Okay.
Like smash.
Okay. It's gross.
The 1 pieces of cinnamon. Next, grater the nutmeg just a little.
Okay.
What are we?
Nuez moscada in Spanish.
Because it's too much nutmeg, usually you must getting sleep deeper.
Yep.
So just put it out here.
1 piece of pandan leaves.
It's a beautiful day.
Bite
it. Let's go.
Okay. Okay. Excuse me.
Fast 1 pieces of lemongrass. We add, this is called tamarind.
And how much of the tamarind? This is like one fruit, Norians, one...
One, this is one mera.
Berapa?
We add, just use 4 pieces.
Okay.
Sour. Salt taste from tamarind.
Yeah, you in Indonesia have a lot of beautiful and incredible, amazing
plants.
Yeah. Tonight. This one is the sugar arenal.
Arena,
good. That you have to measure the grams of the arena sugar.
Yes.
Yeah, that you can substitute with the honey, but honey just put in the last of you make it jam.
Last step.
Yeah, last step.
Okay. So here, how much more? This is like 15 grams,
yeah.
15 to 20 grams.
Okay.
And if you don't use that and use honey, you can use like more or less double the honey, you know? Like maybe 40 grams of honey or how much honey do we use?
Maybe if you don't use arenga sugar, you can use honey like for 1 mug, like to 2 teaspoon tablespoon.
2 teaspoons.
Yeah,
2 teaspoons. Okay, so much.
Yeah, or maybe 1 teaspoon. Depend on what you want to taste, more sweet or just, just a little sweet.
Perfect. And the water that you put at first was more or less?
300 milliliters.
300 milliliters, okay.
So for one bottle
like this.
Yes.
This is your product, the Reina Jamu.
Yes.
And what is the meaning of Reina?
Reina.
Where does this come from, your brand name?
Okay, Reina is a regeneration of Jamu. So regeneration again about Jamu. Like Reina, it's mean from our family name, Reina. It's from my mother, Ratna, and in from my younger brother, Indra, and A, it's Ayu. So we called Reina. So this is like generation to generation, different generation, we can consume jamu. So jamu can consume every generation, not only for older people, but younger people, and maybe for the child too.
Well, it's very good.
Yes.
Pues ya hemos llegado al final de este episodio. ¿Qué te ha parecido? ¿Has aprendido alguna cosa nueva? Recuerda dejarme tus impresiones por aquí abajo, debajo del vídeo, en los comentarios, que me encanta siempre leerlo y ver qué te va aportando esta aventura herbal. También quería recordarte antes de despedirme que te suscribas al canal de YouTube, que actives las notificaciones y estés atento a los próximos episodios que irán llegando. Y por último, te dejo también aquí abajo del vídeo un enlace para descargarte la guía herbal gratuita si quieres profundizar más en el mundo de las plantas medicinales, para aprender a utilizar 7 remedios súper útiles en terapéutica y aprender sobre sus usos, propiedades y cultivo. Te lo dejo por aquí abajo y nos vemos en el siguiente episodio. ¡Chao, chao!